You want to see the little ducky? The little yellow ducky? What sound does a little yellow ducky make? Does he go quack, quack? Yeah, these are cookies, little yellow cookies. What about this pussycat? What do you think? What sound does he make? That's a ducky. That's a ducky. That's very good.
Any word on Rick?
Your brother called 10 minutes ago. There's no change.
No heart donor.
Not yet.
No, but he's on top of the list now.
So. Still, that means somebody has to die for him to live. I hate them rooting for that to happen.
Well, people die, honey. And if when they do, then they can save someone else's life, at least it gives their death some meaning. You and I know that better than most.
That's right. Well, I can't think about that right now, because it's B.E.D. time.
Oh, no.
This little guy.
Oh, no, it's bedtime.
Ew, Robbie.
You want me to put him up? Can
oh,
I do it?
Oh, no, that's okay, Dad. I got a couple.
Sure.
Thanks. Yeah. I'll take those.
Guess I'm just still a little bit of a stranger around here. It'd take Michelle a little while to trust me with him.
Hey, I would say that went smooth sailing. You are now ready for the main event.
Well, I hope it went smoothly. You've done it twice before.
Well, third time's a charm, that's what they say.
Oh, it's time for the honeymoon!
Speaking of the honeymoon, am I gonna have to babysit Shane while you guys are away?
I don't need a babysitter.
How's about you both coming up and spend some time with me in Tulsa?
All right, cool, let's
no,
go.
No, not cool. You guys have finals.
Yeah, we're gonna have to figure out some other time for them. Oh, my, excuse me. I said I wouldn't believe it till I saw it with my own eyes.
Oh,
Phil! Did you meet up with your mama, dear?
Yeah, we met up in Chicago. I drove in with her. Uncle John.
Hello, Will.
How are you?
Great to see you.
Hey,
you're doing great work down in Texas. You going to stay there?
Well, you know, Dad, I don't got any plans to settle down anywhere just
yet. Yeah, figures.
Oh, my, there's Mara. Hold on, I'll be right back. Hold on.
Hi, stranger.
Hey, look at you. Europe certainly does agree with you, doesn't it?
Oh, you're getting gallant. Well, I'm getting used to it. It was a bit of a hard adjustment, but it's okay.
So how's Matt and little Maureen?
Oh, they're fine. They're fine. Maureen's in school, and Matt stayed with her, and that's why.
Well, you tell him that's no excuse, all right?
Tell him
I say hi. All right.
Him.
Excuse us.
So how are you? I hear that you've been going out with Holly Reed.
Holly, well,
yeah. How's that going?
Holly.
It's great for me, not so good for him. God, you're beautiful.
Oh, thank you. Well, I guess I'm not up on all the local gossip.
Yeah, Holly threw me over for him, God knows why.
He can't accept the fact that I'm better looking and more intelligent than he is.
Come on, you just can't accept the fact that you caught her on the rebound because you decided I was too much man for her, plain and simple.
I see some things never change.
Bill, it is so good to see you.
Yeah, you too,
Just, you look great.
Well, thank
you. Hey, how are you enjoying working with Lewis Oil?
You know, it's a job, and I still have oil under my fingernails.
Well, that makes you a real oil man.
Yeah, I suppose it does.
So, are you enjoying Texas?
I'm having a lot of fun, getting a little restless, though.
It's good to have you home.
Hey,
it really
thanks.
Is.
Thank you.
Ooh, excuse me.
You don't approve? No, I don't.
This is a nice surprise. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm just hoping to make peace with your father.
I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon.
Dad, please don't make a scene.
Mom, Dad has every right to be angry with me.
Well, you lied to me. You lied to Reba. You went after Romeo without the police, which put Mara in danger. Actually, what I feel right now is way beyond anger.
But everything worked out, and Tony ended up rescuing me.
What if he hadn't?
Miss Lewis, I'm sorry. Look, I don't want to ruin your rehearsal dinner. I came by to drop this off. All right, and say thank you for trusting me in the first place.
You realize
Tony that that trust may never happen again.
You know what? I'm hoping I can change that. Because I want to keep seeing your daughter, and I want your approval.
Sweetie, you're ignoring our guests. Hi, Tony.
Hi.
Thank you for the gift. I hope you'll stay.
I don't think that's such a good idea.
It is. Thanks, Mom.
Why would you do that? Why would you invite him to stay?
Because at least now we know where he is.
Yeah, he's alone with her daughter.
I don't think he's going to be leaving the party with her. In fact, I can guarantee it.
I cannot stop thinking about you. I close my eyes and I see you. I go to sleep and I am dreaming about you.
All I want to do is talk about you. I think about kissing you and how it feels to be held by you.
I think about you with somebody else and I start to go crazy.
Tony, I don't want anybody else, only you. And when I'm not with you, I'm only wishing that I could be.
Not awake. What's wrong?
Tony's here, and Mara's with him.
Oh.
I don't have anything against Tony. It's just that love is hard enough without a bunch of Santoses on your back.
Do you think love is hard?
I'm not saying it isn't wondrous. But after the initial emotional and physical rush, what do you have?
More emotional and physical rushes.
Kathy, I'm serious. What you've got is the day-to-day, we gotta make this work stuff, and that lasts a whole lot longer than the starry-eyed June moon stuff.
But if you're in love, you can get through the day-to-day stuff. And if it's the real thing, Reva, you can work through anything.
And what about the mistakes and the lies? How does love survive that?
You did. Or you wouldn't be marrying Josh tomorrow.
Yeah, well, I still worry about hurting him. And I guess the cliche is true. I can't live with him, and I sure as heck don't want to live without him.
Well, you know what? I can't live without Richard. You know, I just wondered, you know, who was I before I met him? I didn't know anything about love.
He's a great guy.
He's a wonderful guy. I can't believe he loves me back.
You know the feeling when I look at Joshua and I see him smile at me? I wonder, how the heck did I get so lucky?
Well, here's to luck, love, and may it last an eternity.
So Reva tells me there's a whole bunch more Lewis's due in tomorrow.
Yes, yes, there are. We got Mindy coming in and Trish, and I understand Dylan's going to be here as well, and Rusty, is that right?
Yeah, yeah, I'm pretty sure they're coming in.
That's good.
Yeah, we haven't had a Lewis Shane reunion in a long time.
Far too long.
You happy?
I'm sorry, do I not look happy?
Oh, yeah, sure. But I do know my daughter. With her, you get a whole lot of happiness. And then you get a whole lot of grief.
Sounds like true love to me.
Yeah, reckon it does. First two times, it didn't stick.
I know that. And right now, you're thinking that this time it's not gonna stick either, right? Let me tell you something. We've changed. We know what to expect from each other now.
She is gonna surprise you from time to time.
No.
Yeah, you heard it here first.
Well, let me tell you this. I got a few surprises up my sleeve, too.
Oh, no.
Hey, Ed, you know, Michelle's just got a lot on her mind right now. I'm sure she didn't mean it the way it, you know, the way it seemed.
I used to know everything she was thinking.
Well, Please. Even I don't know what Michelle's thinking sometimes.
Yeah, I guess it's just hard for me still to adjust to the fact that she's married, has a son of her own. You know?
Yeah. Well, hey, I appreciate you not treating me like the guy who stole your little girl away.
Oh, come on. Just the fact you love her and make her happy, that's all that matters.
Yeah. I know it, it may not feel that way, but she is happy that you're home. She is. You have a real closeness with her and Rick.
We used to be close.
No, I see it now. I do.
You close with your family?
It's a little complicated. Michelle and my mother they don't really get along.
Yeah, I've heard things about your mother. Formidable woman, huh?
Yeah, you could say that, among other things. Yeah. It hasn't been too easy for Michelle, but, you know, I'm hoping that things will get better with time.
What about you and your mother? I mean, I know that I didn't come cheap. Can you at least tell me where the ransom money came from?
Not from my mother. So, what do you think? Did I pass the test?
No, I don't believe in testing people.
Test?
I don't believe in testing
people. Oh,
well,
that's good to know. That's good to know.
Just self-preservation, actually.
Yeah. Ed, I just, I do want you to know that I love your daughter very much, more than anything. And, well, I would do anything to protect her, to make her happy.
Well, that pretty much puts us on the same page, then.
Well, he's all settled in.
He's quite the little reader, too, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So it took me back, sitting over there with him on my lap, reading that. You remember? No, of course you wouldn't remember. You're too little, but I used to read you that book all the time.
Of course I remember. I remember everything. I remember the games, the stories, the love.
I remember that, too.
Yeah, I thought it was gonna last forever, but it didn't.
The love never went away.
No. But you did. You left, and, there was a huge hole in my life where you used to be.
Is that what this is about? Is that why you took Robbie away from me?
I'm afraid I just don't want Robbie to love you the way that I did. I don't want him to be hurt when you leave us again. I'm sorry, Dad.
No, that's all right. That's okay.
No, I didn't mean for all that to come out.
You know what? I'm going to go upstairs and say goodnight to our little man, okay?
Okay.
You have to be allowed to say what's ever on your mind.
I guess I didn't know it was all on my mind, all that stuff.
Honey, look, I'm sorry I left. But at the time, it seemed to be a question of survival.
What did you think about my survival?
Well, I thought that you would be better off here with Rick. You know, I knew that I was going to a really bad place, and I knew that you were going to want to try to help me, and I didn't want to take you down with me.
I needed you, though. I was on trial for murder. I was so scared. I was so alone, and I couldn't imagine what was so important in Africa that you couldn't come back for me.
Oh, please stop it. I can't stand the fact that I caused you any pain.
It wasn't just the bad times, you know? I wish that you were here for my wedding, Robbie's birth. And I know that you did all these great things in Africa, and you saved a lot of lives, but I just wish that sometimes You were less of a hero and more of a father.
I wish I were more of a father, too.
Why didn't you come back? Ross called. I mean, I wrote.
Because I was sick.
What do you mean you were sick?
There were times when I didn't even think I was gonna live.
Why didn't you tell us? We would have come for you. We would have brought you home.
You were on trial. And I was too sick to travel. I didn't think it was going to serve any purpose at all to tell you about it. I mean, you already had enough to worry about.
I'm sorry, Dad.
Don't be. Disappointing people seems to be a habit of mine.
No. Can you just tell me one more thing? When you got better, why didn't you come back then?
Other things happened.
You can tell me.
No, I can't. Look, that part of it, it just has to stay in the past for now. It's got to stay where it belongs.
Okay, well, when you're ready, will you tell me?
Yes, I will.
I do want Robbie to know you. And I want him to love you the way Rick and I do.
I just want to be who you need me to be.
Just you. That's all I need.
Oh, my. I just hope I can figure out who that is.
What a nice surprise.
Carmen, you weren't invited to Lewis's dinner.
No, I wasn't. But I would like a moment alone with Mara. You know, why don't you go talk with Bill Lewis and find out what happened to him and my little girl? Come on, Antonio. I'm not going to bite her.
It's okay. Go ahead. Go talk to
her. I'm watching you.
I want you to know, Mara, that I'm not going to say a word about what I saw that morning.
What morning?
The morning I found Romeo asleep on the couch at Inferno and you rushing out of the office half-dressed.
I'm surprised you didn't tell Tony the second you saw him.
I care about my nephew. He may not have killed Catalina, but if he were to discover you and Romeo in that way, someone would be dead. And I wouldn't want to be responsible for that.
You're right.
I'm serious, Mara. Whatever happened between you and Romeo stays between you and Romeo. Unless, of course, you're planning on telling Tony about it.
Well, that's none of your business.
I'm sure Tony expects complete honesty from you. But then if he did find out that you slept with Romeo, it just might shatter all that love and trust he has for you. On the other hand, it is possible that he could move past it and forgive you and love you again. Oh, well. Good luck, Mara. I wish you and Tony all the best in the world.
Tony Santos.
Oh!
You better be good tomorrow. Never mind the folks. I'll be the one coming after you. See this?
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's right.
You sure you should be making threats like that? You're the one who dumped Pilar.
Hey, wait, no. Wait a minute now. She dumped me, all right? We both knew it wasn't working out, only she had the guts to say it.
It's true. Well, that sounds like Pilar.
It's true.
So what, you guys still keep in touch, or? What? Well, we tried the whole, you know, let's be friends thing, but, you know how that goes. It just didn't work out. What has she been up to these days? She's in Italy, you know, she's...
Italy?
Yeah, she's staying out.
Get out.
She got herself a role in an independent film.
No, she didn't.
Yeah, she's really happy. To Pilar. Mm. What about you?
Mm.
What have you been up to?
I've been traveling a lot. Now I'm working down in Texas and just enjoying the ladies, having a little fun. You should come check. Hey, Mom,
hi,
I was
sweetie.
Just telling Tony here how hard I work. Do you know Tony Santos? Tony Santos is my beautiful
Tony Santos.
Mommy.
Hi, nice to meet you.
You too, nice to meet you.
Yes. I have to go because I won't be long, but there's just somebody I'm going to go check up on, okay?
All right.
See you.
Attention, please, everybody. Excuse me. May I please have your attention? First of all, I would just like to say thank you for coming here tonight. And thank you for having the same faith in me and Reva that she and I have in each other. Now, just a second here, just a second. We are living proof that you can continue to love and to learn and to grow in a lifetime. In fact, I can't remember a time when I did not love Reva Shane. Aww. Of course, it is easy to love somebody who has a spirit that's so, I don't know, how should we put this, wild? Yeah?
Oh, you wouldn't be talking about me.
I am talking about you.
No, Donna. Not anymore.
In fact, I have proof of this wild spirit. Certain friends of mine have tipped me off to a certain videotape that exists of a certain night in a bar, the Blue Orchid Bar, I believe.
Oh, you wouldn't.
I would.
You couldn't.
I could, and I did. So if you would all please turn your attention to this television set where my beautiful assistant is now standing. Hit it, big guy.
Thank you.
Yeah, baby.
We will continue with part two of Guiding Light in a moment. We will continue with part two of Guiding Light in a moment.
Tonight on 60 Minutes 2, can stem cells really cure diseases? Yes, they can, and we've got the proof. One little boy making medical history. Tonight at 8, 7 Central.
Wiener Schnitzel, America's most wanted hot dog. Now for just $2, get a chili cheeseburger and a chili cheese dog. And stop in for your chance to win a 2002 Camaro.
Vaccinations protect your children against diseases like measles, mumps, chickenpox, and many others. You might not think these diseases are a serious threat today because you don't see or hear about them, but they are still around. If we stop vaccinating against these diseases, more people will become infected. Vaccinating your children will keep them healthy and safe. For more information, call Kern Family Healthcare at 1-800-391-2000. Remember, if you love them, immunize them.
Little brother!
For public transportation, get on your way on the Get Bus today.
Woo! A woman wanted for a crime leads police on a high-speed chase through Kern County. The story coming up on Eyewitness News at 5.
The television event of the summer, Joan of Arc, CBS Sunday.
I hate thinking that you were so sick and Rick and I couldn't help you.
Well, honey, I'm fine now. I really am. Look, I can even lift the coffee cup up and down.
Amazing.
Yeah, isn't it?
So when you got better, where exactly were you in Africa and who were the people that you were helping?
Honey, remember your dad said he didn't want to talk about that tonight.
Right. Okay.
We'll talk about it soon, I promise.
I'll get it. Vanessa!
Danny, hi. Am I interrupting? Am I bothering you?
No. Come on in.
Oh, good to meet you.
Oh, how wonderful to see you. And how's that beautiful little baby boy of yours?
He's doing great.
Is he good? I'm so proud of you. I know you're Your mother would be so proud of you.
Yeah, I think about her a lot, too.
Yes.
Hi. I heard you were back. I had to come see you.
I'm so glad you did.
Yeah. You look, I don't know, a little worn, or have you been sick or something?
No, no. It's just a long flight back to the States.
Oh, sure. I can imagine.
You're here for Josh and Reva's wedding? How are they?
They're great. They're very happy, and...
Oh, we have that laundry we had to fold. You know what I mean?
What? I don't do laundry. What? Oh, yeah. I'm an expert folder, so I'm told.
That's code for why don't they just disappear. You know, we could do that, too. It's nice out. You want
to... Yeah, I'd love to go sit outside if you have the time.
I got the time. Okay. Let's go.
Oh, I forgot to ask
laundry.
Vanessa about Bill.
You'll get a chance later on. So tell me, did you get some things settled with your father?
It's the beginning. Where did you find him? Like, what was he doing, Danny?
Honey, I really think that's for him to discuss with you.
I don't know if he'll tell me. I get the feeling that he's hiding something from me.
Get up. You can do your lounging later. We're dropping the bomb on Tony, and we're going to do it in a way that causes the most damage, starting now.
Are they different? Oh, I was talking about the stars. You know, I can't remember exactly where you were in Africa, but I remember in fifth grade learning that the stars are different, you know, below the equator.
I didn't spend a lot of time looking at the stars.
Were most of the people that you worked with AIDS victims?
Yeah, AIDS, malaria, typhoid, Ebola, a lot of diseases we don't have names for yet.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure your skill really helped them. What about you? Did going away help you?
Going away or running away?
You're back now.
And Maureen's still dead. And so is Eve.
Your children are here. And your children need you very much.
It'd be nice if we could just turn back the clock, you know? Just undo all the mistakes. Just get a second chance on everything.
Yeah. I guess it would be nice, but I don't know. If I think about turning back the clock, maybe I wouldn't have married Billy. We had some pretty good years there at the beginning. And we have Bill.
All that heartache.
Look, the reason I wanted to see you is that I heard about Rick and how sick he is. And I'm so sorry.
He needs a new heart. It's just tough, you know, someone as strong and...
So what are his chances?
Of getting one?
Yeah.
Not very good. That's the thing about organ donation, you know, people don't really realize yet how many lives could be saved.
Yeah, I know. So, Anne, what are you gonna do if he doesn't get one?
You mean, am I gonna drink again?
Yeah. Are you gonna drink again? Or are you gonna go back to Africa?
What are you asking?
Well, it seems to me that whatever you went to Africa to find, you didn't find it. And I know that every time you tried to find relief in a drink, you sure didn't find it.
Well, maybe I'll just have to stick around here then. Do the best I can for the people I love.
Sounds good to me. I mean, nobody
is telling you that you have to be perfect, Ed Bauer.
Come on. Let me be perfect.
You can keep on trying. Okay, so take care of yourself. I've got a party I've got to get back to.
Say hi to Matt.
I will. And Rick and Michelle are really lucky to have you. And I'll see you before I go, okay?
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to introduce to you Joshua Lewis and his Oklahoma Oil Men. We are going to do a gusher of a song for you tonight. We would like to dedicate that song to one of our own, the lovely and talented, the fabulous filly, Reva Shane.
Did he call me a filly?
Yes, ma'am, I certainly did. And I would like to hope for you that you will always have that wild streak in you. And that I will always have the stamina to keep up with you without having a heart attack. Hit it.
You got a smile so bright. You know you could have been a candle. I'm holding you so tight. You know you could have been a candle. You know you could have been a groom.
Oh,
the way you smell so sweet.
Get it on now.
You know you could have been some perfume. Well, you could have been anything that you wanted to, and I can tell.
Woo! The way you do the things you do. Oh, baby.
As pretty as you are.
She's cunning and crafty.
Everything that was meant for me, my daughter, is gonna have.
And she's making new plans.
Rick Forrester and your daughter, you're nuts.
It's Sheila's chance for revenge.
You are a perfect match for this young man, so get with the program.
And she's ready to get it on.
He is married, not for long.
The bold and the beautiful.
Where's Vanessa?
She went back to the party.
You look tired. Maybe you should call it a night.
I think I will. Don't you stay up too late.
Okay, Dad.
Be so sick of having me back. Take care, buddy. I'll see you in the morning.
Good night.
Hey, Dad. Welcome home.
Thanks.
Welcome. What did I do? Can I do it again? Again?
You do it every day. Loving me. Being a great dad to Robbie.
Mm-hmm.
Taking care of me. Giving me back my father.
Well, you know, it's all in a day's work.
Seriously. You went halfway around the world. You found my father and you brought him back to me. That's pretty amazing.
I love you, and I want you to be happy. You know, I look at you and who you are, and I figure that I must have had a lot to do with who Ed and Maureen were. I couldn't bring Maureen back, but I could do everything in my power to bring your father home, so.
Do you know that you're incredible?
Yes, I do. But I like hearing it from you. I just figured that your father has helped probably thousands of people in Africa, and now it's your turn to be the person he helps. I love you.
I love you.
How could you keep this? A secret from me?
What, are you angry? Why?
No, of course not. You were wonderful.
Thank you.
I love it here. I'm just so happy.
Really?
Yes, really. Yes, I'm around my friends and my family and Josh and Reaver getting married.
Right, again. Yes.
And this time it's going to be forever.
And we're going to be forever, right? And
you? You promised me something.
Anything.
You promised me that our life isn't going to be this emotional roller coaster, that we're going to be strong. We're going to be awesome, and our life is going to be full of passion. You promise me that, please?
I promise, and I also promise that I'll never leave you.
Oh, okay.
And that our love will always shelter you.
Hey, promise me something else.
What?
And you're never gonna surprise me like that on the dance floor again.
Well, I thought you liked it.
I did, but I would have liked it better if I would have known about it.
Oh, right.
I'm going to go get you a glass of champagne.
Okay. I'll be waiting right here.
So?
Hey.
I didn't mean to overhear or butt in or anything, but did you say no more surprises? Does that mean you're going to tell Cassie that you're selling cars?
I will. I will.
You say that every time we talk about this. Richard, she just said she doesn't want any more surprises.
Well, this is going to be a nice one, you know, and I'm going to have to be really nice to tell her, and then I will tell her, I promise.
Mm. Well, you better, because the longer it takes, the more unpleasant that surprise is going to be. Thank you so much for coming tonight. I'm so glad that you're here.
Well, what did Carmen want to talk to you about?
You know, treat my nephew well, or I'll come after you kind of stuff.
But she should mind her own business. I'm going to talk to her about that. That's not...
No, Tony, don't. What? Don't. It doesn't matter. She's right. I should treat you well.
But you do. You know that.
Yeah, sometimes. Most of the time. And from now on, all of the time.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well, I like that. I should go.
Oh, but it's so early.
No, I know, but I got a long way to go with your parents. I shouldn't push it.
But you will be at the wedding tomorrow, right?
I wouldn't miss it, babe. Good night.
Yeah.
Don't hurt me.
You are truly amazing.
Well, thank you. You're going to have to remind me of that over the next 40 years.
Yeah, well, you can count on that.
Thank you.
But as far as your singing and dancing?
Uh-oh. Here it comes.
One good turn deserves another.
What do you have planned?
You'll see.
Uh-oh.
Excuse me, everyone. Don't you all agree that what these gentlemen did was truly remarkable?
Yes.
Y'all
so
talented.
We'll be here till Thursday.
However, one good turn deserves another.